Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Good morning viewers, I welcome you all to another set of videos which is related to Saturn transit. So there are two versions as per the Saturn transit is concerned. There are two panjangam. One, as per Trikanita panjangam, the Saturn transit is already completed on 24th of January 2020, and as per the Vakya panchanga, the Saturn transit is going to take place on 26th of December 2020, which is on a Saturday, auspicious day. In this video, we will be seeing each and every zodiac sign, the impact of the Saturn's transit. So if you have not subscribed to this channel, keep this subscribed so that you will receive my instant updates. Also, if you like this video, give a like and share with your friends and group. Generally, Saturn transit takes place once in every 2.5 years. In some cases, it may take even 3 years. For the present scenario, it already took 3 years time to get the transition. So this time, the year 2020, Saturn is moving from Sagittarius to Capricorn to be his own house, and it is going to be a ruler there. You can see, as per the Trikanita Panjanga, planetary positions during the 24th of January 2020 is being shown here. As per the Trikanita Panjanga, where the Saturn transit already took place on 24th of January 2020, during that time, you could see the Saturn being a ruler there in Capricorn. Along with Saturn, you could see Sun, the Mercury and Moon are together. And in Sagittarius, you could see the Jupiter is being a ruler there along with Ketu. On Scorpio, you could see the Mars being a ruler there. On Aquarius, you could see the Venus, and at Gemini, you could see the Rahu being seated there. So this is the planetary position as per the Trikanita Panjanga during the 24th of January 2020, when actually the Saturn transit took place. Now we will see on the coming December 26, 2020, as per the Vakya Panjanga. This is as per the temples. See, in most of the South Indian temples, they follow the Vakya Panjanga, and they will do all the archanas and abhishekas on this particular day, which is considered to be the most auspicious, and we could see the planetary position on that particular day. On 26th of December 2020, you could see the planetary position where in Aries, the Moon and Mars are together, where the Mars is a ruler there. And in the second house, in Taurus, Rahu being there. Scorpio, you could see Ketu is there seated along with Venus. And in Sagittarius, you have the Sun and the Mercury. And in Capricorn, you could see the Saturn being the ruler there, along with Saturn, Jupiter is also being seated there. So this is the position of the planets during that particular period. So in the upcoming this Saturn's transit, as per the Vakya Panjanga, you could see the all planets are within the Rahu Ketu's limits. So we call this as a Kala Sarpa Dosha. This particular Saturn transit is going to take place on a particular day where the entire planetary positions are within the Rahu Ketu's control. So it may be even some dangerous positions also, where there are some good things as well as some bad things happen, because all the powers are being absorbed by the Rahu Ketu when the complete planets are on particular one side. So generally we call this as a Kala Sarpa Dosha. So this is the time when the Saturn actually is moving from Sagittarius to Capricorn. This particular Saturn transit, two zodiac signs feel better. One particular zodiac sign being Scorpio, where the second half Saturn period is getting over. Once the Saturn moves away from Sagittarius to Capricorn, the other zodiac sign being Taurus, where Saturn being in the 8th house so far is moving to the 9th house. So this seems to be a better place for the Taurus. But unfortunately for Gemini, this Saturn transit is not so favorable, as Saturn comes and sits on the 8th house. But generally for Gemini, Saturn is always a ruler at the 8th house, and it also occupies the 9th house. Somewhat Sagittarius zodiac sign, they feel happy because they are coming to the last fag end of the 7.5 period of Saturn. So they are coming to the last 2.5 years, where the Saturn will not give much bad effects because it had already given much bad influence on the first 5 years. So this seems to be a better period for Sagittarius. For Capricorn as well as Aquarius, they are falling under the 7.5 period of Saturn. Fortunately for these two zodiac signs, Saturn being the ruler and it occupies its own house, it will not give much harm or much bad effect when compared to other zodiac signs. So comparatively it is better for them, like a school teacher giving punishment to others rather than not giving much punishment to their own children. So this is the concept where the Saturn will not give much of trouble to the own zodiac sign. Now we'll see for each and every zodiac sign, right from Aries to Pisces, what are the benefits out of this Saturn's transit. Taurus, the second zodiac sign. For Taurus, Jupiter moves from the 8th house to the 9th house, and the 9th house there is a conjunction of planets. Already Saturn is there as a ruler at Capricorn. Now Jupiter moves along with Saturn and becomes a Raja Yoga there. For Taurus, when the time of the Jupiter transit, the lord of the Taurus, Venus, is at 6th house. So they may find some enmities during this period, either it at workplace or at the residence also. You can find the lord of the second house and the 5th house is seated at the 6th house initially. So for the first 2 to 3 months, there may be a erratic behavior with the children. They may not listen to them properly, and even the studies will be very dull. Also in the family life, they will not find peace in their house. There will be some disturbances always. And there is always a difference of opinion between the husband and wife. But you can see the 7th house lord is being seated at the 11th house. So chances of getting good revenue during the first initial period till March. So those who are doing business from the time of Jupiter transit till the March 2021, there are chances getting good revenue. This is especially because of the Mars at the 11th house. Jupiter from there, it starts aspecting the Rahu, where it is seated at the Lagna or Ascendant itself. So during the Rahu Kedu transit, the Rahu moves from the second house to the Ascendant. So people start finding difficulty in their health reasons. They would have got some diseases and they would have spent time on that. So now after this Jupiter transit, the difficulties will get reduced. The illness will also get into cure. So the aspect, the Jupiter aspect will be a good fortune for the Taurus people. Also Jupiter starts aspecting the third house of Taurus. So their hard work will get in, fetch them a very good results. So they will try hard and get success in their life. You can see Taurus, Jupiter aspects the 5th house of Taurus. So because of this Jupiter is aspecting on the 5th house, there are chances for some people, the students might study well. Also for those who are expecting kids, they will get a good kid during this period. The chances of getting married is there in this Jupiter transit. For many who are not yet married, there are chances to get a good married life and settle in their life. For some people who are looking for jobs abroad, the chances of getting into foreign countries, either for studies as well as for the workplace. Taurus, Ketu is at the 7th house, which will definitely disturb certain relationship between the husband and wife. It also gives some conflict in the business projects also. So this will have a huge impact in their personal life as well as in their business life. So those who are interested to start a new business, so they will find difficulty after the March 2021. So in all, we could say for Taurus, this Jupiter transit will give them around 75 to 80% positive results.